All right, so ladies and gentlemen, this is the papyrus plant. The plant of the papyrus is considered a sacred plant, as I mentioned before, for two reasons. The first reason, the stem of the plant looks like a triangular shape, a symbol of eternity, immortality, and everlasting. This one, it looks like the berry. The second reason, the flower looks like sun rays, symbol of the god Amun-Ra, the god of the sun. How the Egyptian people made the first paper in history? First of all, they cut the stem of the plant according to the size that they used to want, like a smaller, bigger, whatever, like any of these size. After they cut it to one like this, then they start to remove the outer green part, and the outer green part is used for making sandals, hats, furniture, and many other things. The inner white part is the most important part. This is the one that is used for making the sheet of paper. I mean the white one or the white part. So they used to cut it to small ones, like this. But these ones, it contains much of water, so it's easy to break. So for reducing the percentage of the water in one of these, they're using this one or this hammer. What the Egyptian wives sometimes use.
That's what ours use. Yeah.
I missed that.
So after that, using this rolling pin, forget get completely of the water. As you see, too much of water, get outside. Then we put the slice in the water for 6 days in the water. Forget a white one or a white slice like this one, or white paper like one of these. Forget the brown or the darker, they put the slice in the water much longer, like 15 days, okay? For reducing the percentage of sugar in the brown one, like 2.5%, and the white one like 5%. Then they get 2 pieces of linen like these ones, and they put the slices in horizontal and vertical lines. First of all, they put all the horizontal ones, and then after they finish the horizontals, then they put the vertical ones exactly like this. Until they finish, and then they get another piece of linen, and then put them under this press for another 6 days, okay? So 6 days in the water, and 6 days in the press. Then after 6 days, they get a paper like this, original papyrus paper that made out of papyrus plant, because sometimes they make like imitation. They have papers made out like a sugar cane or banana leaves. Under some source of light, you can see clearly a horizontal and vertical lines, you see? And some of that points, these ones are the rest of sugar which make the slices stick together, okay? Not putting any chemical substances or any glue, because some others, they can put a chemical substance or glue for making the slices stick together. After having a paper like this, for sending for faculty of artists for painting all of these ones. All of these ones are scenes from tombs and temples. The most important one, this one, is called the Final Judgment or Final Court, which is the original one is kept now in British Museum in London. The Egyptian people believed in life after death, so they thought that the dead person after his death is kneeling in front of 14 judges like this, and everyone asks him a question like, did he steal? Did you believe the Nile? Pollution of the Nile of the Christian at the time. Did you disturb your neighbors? Did you do something wrong during the whole of your life? He replies by negative confession, saying, I testify, I never lie. I have never polluted the Nile. I have never disturbed my neighbors. I have never done anything wrong with you in the whole of my life. So some of them feel sympathy towards him, some others don't believe in him, so they get him and they get the heart out of the body, and this is why during the process of mummification, they not get the heart out of the body, so they put the heart here, and on the other side of the scale, they're putting the feather of justice. If his heart is heavier, means guilty or sinner, he'll go hell. But if the heart is lighter, it means good, and he will go paradise or the United States. He will go Horus, the god of the protection, will get him to paradise to introduce him to the god Osiris, the god of afterlife, his wife Isis, and sister Nephthys, the god of magic. And this is the god, his name Thoth, the god of writing and wisdom. He keep recording all the results of the final judgment. This is the final judgment or final court. There is another story here, it's called the Tree of Life. five birds representing five main ages of the human being. This one's called Maydun Gize. This is the first example of painting ever known in the history. Watch representing the identification between upper and lower of Egypt. This is a zodiac form. And the original one, by the way, it's kept now in the Louvre Museum in Paris, okay? But we have another plaster copy in the Temple of Dendera, around 60 kilometers north of this place. This figure you are going to see clearly tomorrow in the Valley of the Kings, in the tombs that you are going to visit. You see the sky goddess. The Egyptian people thought that the sky goddess Nut swallowed the sun after sunset and be pregnant during the night. And then the next morning, she is giving the birth again to the sun to give the life and new day to people all over the world. She's touching the world by two arms and two legs, representing the four cardinal points. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are interested to write your name in the hieroglyphic, here there is an artist in 2 minutes that's going to write your name in the hieroglyphic in a cartouche form like this, and it's charged 10 Egyptian pounds extra. And each masterpiece, if you are interested to get something here, you can see the two numbers, the model number and the price. This price in Egyptian pound, and you can pay in Egyptian or American dollar, or you can use your Visa card or MasterCard. For transporting the stuff, they have a tube, it's easy way for transportation. Also, you get your stuff with the guarantee, which it means you get something original under the control of the Ministry of Tourism. Thank you very much for paying attention. Enjoy your time. All of my colleagues, they are very smart and are going to help you as much as they can. They will answering also all of your questions if you have any question and they know lots about this. And if you have a very, very difficult question, come back to me. As you know, I know everything. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Have a good time.